Hey everybody, welcome back to So Awkward. I'm Don, and I've got another pro wrestling crate. I still haven't canceled it. This is the only box that I still get, somehow. It survived the calamity of 2017, where I canceled every subscription box. I actually canceled this one. But then I came back. Because the theme is animals. For some reason, that appealed to me. Can't remember why.
You're watching So Awkward. This is Freddy Krueger saying, hi!
I remember why. So here's what I'm hoping will be in here. British Bulldog, Jake the Snake Roberts. They've got to be in here. They're the greatest animal-themed wrestlers of all time. Two of my all-time favorites. If it's just a box full of George the Animal Steel stuff, I'm going to be pissed off. Maybe one item by George the Animal Steel will be okay, but... yeah, I want Jake the Snake and the British Bulldog. I'd be okay with Coco Beware, the Birdman, and his parrot Frankie. What else? What else? Let's predict. What else is there? I'm drawing a blank here. Did Colt Cabana ever have an animal? Because somehow Colt Cabana weasels his way into every box. Maybe they'll have Colt Cabana with a weasel. Bobby the Brain? The original weasel? Anyway, let's check it out. Animals. Spoiler alert, the other side of this card contains the contents of this crate. What have we got here? What the hell is this? I don't know what it is, but this is the worst shirt I've ever seen. This is the shirt company. The shirts are usually the best thing. What is this? Gore. I'm assuming it has something to do with Rhino, because his move is he gores. It's a spear, but he calls it the gore. But this is hideous. I'm on the two shirt plan. I'll save the other shirt for last. George the Animal Steel. This is a George the Animal Steel DVD. All right. George the Animal Steel shoot interview. The recently departed George the Animal Steel. So from beyond the grave, he somehow recorded this shoot video. Shoot video for people who aren't wrestling fans. And if you're not a wrestling fan, you haven't made it 5 minutes into this video. Or even 30 seconds into this video. But that's an interview where they tell the truth about a certain subject. Where they come clean. People use shoot to mean like... some kind of controversial. He says something crazy and controversial and making people mad, but yeah, it doesn't really necessarily mean that. Okay, that'll be fun. Usually they always include a DVD. It's usually some like indie show that I have no interest in and I'm not gonna watch, but I might actually watch this. They should include more interviews because that's cool, like behind the scenes stuff. What the hell is this? Micro Brawlers by Pro Wrestling Crate. The Young Bucks, Matt Jackson. I guess you could argue that the Young Bucks falls under the animals theme. I wouldn't argue that, but I mean, you could argue that. Sunglasses. Coco Beware! We got Coco Beware sunglasses! Alright, I'm into it. Do I look like Coco Beware? Anybody? Sometimes love is like a slow dance. You can tiptoe around, but don't make a sound. Silent romance. But sometimes love sounds like a fight. It sounds like an argument. It sounds just like a pile driver. A pile driver.
You're right beside her. Your heart's on fire. She got you hardwired.
I haven't heard that song in 30 years. That wasn't bad. I mean, the singing was bad, but my recollection of the lyrics was pretty good. Sharkboy 316. Bottle opener. I don't get it. Who's Sharkboy? Sharkboy 316. If you're going to have 316, it should be Austin 316, who was also the Texas Rattlesnake, so they could conceivably put him under the animal theme. I don't know what Sharkboy is. What's this? What's this? I see the word Jake. Jake the Snake Roberts. Okay, so Jake the Snake Roberts got into the box, but it's one of these dumb tote bags, which I don't care for. I want a Jake the Snake Roberts shirt. You don't put Jake the Snake Roberts on a tote bag. He's too good for a tote bag. And we've got a pin, which is, oh. Because, you know, every box has a pin. This was Four Horsemen. That's pretty sweet. Clever. And then, so last we've got the shirt. And every box has an autograph print. Let's do the shirt first. Let's save the print for last. Because I feel like this shirt's going to suck. Planet Peacock, Dalton Castle, eat your heart out. I don't know who Dalton Castle is. I always have to explain in every pro wrestling crate unboxing, I'm a WWE guy. That's what I grew up on, that's what I watch now. I don't know much about anything else. I've been watching Lucha Underground on Netflix and it's pretty fun. This isn't from Lucha Underground, maybe it is, I don't know. I haven't been watching that much. I really like the colors and the design is cool, but I don't know who Dalton Castle is. But this one I'll wear, whereas the Rhino one that just looks like a barbed wire wrapped around a disemboweled liver. That's a terrible shirt. All right. So we got Jake the Snake Roberts on a tote bag. We got Coco Beware on sunglass form. Who's this gonna be? Let me see if I can guess. Let me think about animal themed wrestlers. I mean, they could have if this is a Jake the Snake Roberts print, I will go crazy because that would be great. He deserves better than a tote bag. Could it be British Bulldog? It better be Davey Boy Smith, AKA the British Bulldog. I'd even be okay with the Dynamite Kid. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Do they know that a dragon's not a real animal? I'm not complaining because this is badass. That's great. Ricky the Dragon is one of the all-time greats, but it's not an animal. Come on. That's a mythological creature that doesn't exist in nature. And also dragons don't exist. See what I did there? But I'll allow it because it's cool. Let's put him next to Tito. So that was the animal-themed pro wrestling crate. Not their best box. Not their best box by a country mile. But, possibly even their worst box. But I still like them. And next month is tag teams, which is... They revealed that and I thought, one of the things I like about Pro Wrestling Crate, first of all, it's easy to cancel, but you also don't have to cancel it. You can just turn off your subscription. You can turn off auto renew, which is a nice option. So that's what I did. I turned off auto renew and you don't have to check in every month. It's turned off. So I heard that May was tag teams. I was like, oh, I love tag teams. There better be something from the Hart Foundation in there. But I also remember that this month was animals, and I thought, it's probably too late for animals, because I just turned it back on last week, like a week ago. And the day after I turned auto renew back on, they sent me my shipping information for animals, which I thought was pretty on the ball. If I don't like June's, I can suspend it and then wait to see what the theme is, which I think is pretty sweet. Which is a lot easier. Like every other box, You have to cancel it. That I've used. So I didn't love this box, but I still like Pro Wrestling Crate. I think they're cool. Jake the Snake Roberts on a tote bag. I can't forgive him for that. But that's the best print they've had so far. The shirts were both kind of bogus. I guess my favorite item is the Coco Beware sunglasses, which I will never wear. Not because they're ugly, which they are, which is kind of the point, but because I don't wear sunglasses. I don't wear sunglasses, first of all, because I can't see without my glasses. And I don't wear sunglasses because I'm weird. I don't like sunglasses. Everybody loves sunglasses. I don't like having my vision darkened. But anyway, yeah, this box was lame. But somebody out there likes it. If you're a large and you want that rhino shirt, rewind if you want to see a picture of it, because I already threw it and I don't feel like getting up. Comment down below and I'll send it to you, because I don't want it. It's horrible. I'll keep the Dalton Castle one. I'll look up Dalton Castle. Maybe he's cool, but it's a neat looking shirt. I'll wear any shirt just to protect myself from the elements, but I won't wear that rhino shirt because it's horrible. And I like rhino. I do, but that's a terrible shirt. Yeah. So if you want that shirt, let me know and I'll send it to you if you live in the continental United States. I'll even throw in this Shark Boy bottle opener. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. Who did win that Slammy? The first ever Slammy that George Animal Steel ate. Anybody else remember that? Remember that?
How did you get started in the wrestling business?
Do you want to talk to George or Jim Myers? Let's just get it straight.
Jim Myers.
Oh, I thought so. Then we can talk.
All right, great.
You want to talk to George? Hey!
Slower.
You! Slow down. Jim can talk.
Okay, we'll talk to Jim.
Okay, I think you'll like that better.